Although you're watching Proactive London, you'd have needed a lot of stamina to keep up with Guild Esports, which has had an extremely busy and productive time since listing on the LSE back in October 2020. Joining me to tell us all about it is CEO Kal Hourd. Kal, good to speak with you today.
You as well. Thank you.
So, Kal, you're on with full year results, and that's for the 12 months to September the 30th. As I said, you've been hyperactive. Take us through some of the highlights.
Yeah, thanks very much for having me. You know, we had a challenging year. You know, we didn't bring in as much revenue as we expected, but operationally, you know, we won four trophies in esports. We signed you know, four different partnerships, and you know, we developed an infrastructure of staff, you know, from literally zero up to you know, nearly 40 staff. We've got 22 players participating in five different titles on six different rosters. We've got 13 creators, and all in all, we've got a total network audience now of you know, 15 million people. And I'm really optimistic about 2022 because, you know, now that we have the audience to reach, we'll be able to announce more partnerships in due course.
So, I mean, you said over 15 million people watching, but you have a dedicated subscriber base of over 1 million. How fast is that growing?
Yeah, our audience growth has been exceptional, and you know, we expect to broadly double our audience again in 2022. That is going to generate more and more media value, which we can then package up and pass on to brands. You know, brands want us to demonstrate an ROI, and we've laid the foundation for that, and we're really optimistic about 22 being you know, much more productive in terms of revenue than 2021 was.
And it's big brands that you're also signing up with, Kal. So companies like Subway, Samsung, HyperX, and those are worth over £3.9 million over the course of the deals. Are you aiming for other big brands like these ones?
Absolutely, 100%. You know, we earlier this month, you would have seen an announcement of our largest partnership to date, Bitstamp. 4.5 million over 3 years, and Bitstamp is the, you know, the oldest running crypto exchange on the planet, a reputable brand, and we're really proud of that partnership, and that was that gives us great momentum in 2022, and we're really excited to have more come out, and you know, some of them are going to be endemic sponsors, you know, and we're also in conversation with a lot of big global brands.
So what's the attraction for those brands? What are you drawing them in with at Guild Esports? What's your selling card?
Yeah, so, you know, the difficult to reach Gen Z audience is what these brands are looking for. These esports fans, that Gen Z audience, they don't consume media the same way you or I might. You know, they're not reading the paper, they're not watching the news. Their interest lies in video games and watching Twitch and YouTube. You know, as Guild builds a brand and attracts eyeballs because we're winning in esports and we've got content creators that they care about, the brands then come to us as the vehicle to reach those kids and that demographic.
Okay, so that's the sponsors and the brands and obviously the audience. How about investors? How have you managed to attract them? I know that you are trying to broaden that investor base. You're looking at the OTC markets in the US to get some US investors on. What's the draw card for them?
Yeah, so, you know, ultimately, it's going to come down to bringing in revenue, and you know, the shareholders, you know, could obviously have frustration with us right now because you know, our valuation is lower than expected, and my job is to bring it up, and I'm going to do that by continuing to invest in the business, growing in the right areas, and ultimately attracting revenue to the company, and you know, I'm confident that is going to result in value back to our shareholders.
You mentioned news flow post year end, including the 3 year deal with Bitstamp. You also just recently signed a 10-year lease for the Guild Academy in Shoreditch. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, the you know, the HQ really not only does it give us a home and provides a training ground for our pros and our and a place for our content creators to stream from. But there's a lot of commercial opportunities that come with that, that headquarters. You know, we don't yet have a there's significant revenue available for an HQ naming rights spot. You know, some of the individual rooms within that building, you know, in terms of player training rooms and content creator rooms or lounges, et cetera. All of those can come with commercial opportunities. And you know, I see signing that lease as an investment, and we're no doubt going to see the return on that investment, you know, in 2022.
So what sorts of news flow should investors be watching out for in the months ahead, Kal?
Yeah, you know, I think we're at advanced stages in partnerships. I think you know, keep an eye out for that. These deals take a long time to put together, but we're making great progress there. You know, we're also looking to expand and grow our reach and attract more and more eyeballs. Like I mentioned earlier, you know, we expect to broadly double our audience and our total reach, and we do that by winning in game. Our esports teams are performing well, and we do that by, you know, signing content creators and professional players that you know, that our audience cares about. So I think, you know, a couple of key metrics to look for: growth in esports and expansion in esports, and generating revenue. And, you know, as we expand in esports, we're also going to expand our academy and scale that as well.
Great. Well, I hope you'll keep us updated on any new developments. But thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thanks for your time.
That's Kal Hourd. He's the CEO of Guild Esports.